Shallow Keep overall, I'd give maybe a 7 out of 10, 8 out of 10 at a push. For a standalone DLC though by Bungie, it's better than I thought it would be. Story wise, it's a little shorter than I expected, but overall things to do, play for and replayability factor, I'm kind of enjoying it. Today we talk about the edition that arrived on the 5th of the raid, the Vex Offensive. How's it going, guys? My name's DPJ and I'd like to thank you for stopping by and checking out my video. If you do enjoy it, leaving a like really helps out, and subscribe if you want to see more Destiny 2 videos. Okay, so I'll try and keep this short and sweet. The Vex Offensive is a great addition to the game, and it's basically a feature, a new activity that fits the Destiny player down to a T. Destiny for me has always been about grinding for that perfect rolled item. When Shadowkeep dropped and the story for me, which was literally over in under an hour, after this I was left a little speechless. Now I know that the story you can take as a chapter 1 and it will develop over the year, that's cool and I understand that. What I was disappointed in though was the fact that after completing the story, there wasn't really anything else to get my teeth into besides the normal things we had before. It felt like the same grind we've been doing for a year hadn't really changed. Yes, farming for those perfect rolled armors is great, but that's to me something I've always done when I reach or am near a top level. I hate finding that perfect armor piece and wasting my materials infusing it along with my level. So normally I'd hide anything decent I find away in my vault. So yeah, hunting for decent armors is something I've always waited to do. So without having that, Shadowkeep after the story felt a little underwhelming. Now the addition of the artifact was a great move as well as the battle pass, and it was more or less these that kept me playing. But I won't lie to you, coming back from Borderlands, which is the grindiest, most rewarding game I've ever played, Destiny 2 felt a little left behind. I get the whole power level chase, I've done it, I've been doing it for many, many years with Destiny. I just hoped with Shadowkeep we would see a fun addition to it in terms of a feature or activity which helped us level up and was fun to play at the same time, which was something new. And that, guys, is where the Vex Offensive came in. 4 days after Shadowkeep, a whole 3 days and 23 hours after people had completed the story campaign, we got the addition most, including myself, felt Shadowkeep needed. An activity, a 6-man match made activity which rewards you crazy good loot which you can farm forever on end. Now this mod does sound familiar to a mod Bungie in my opinion ruined, and we will get to that in a second. But the Vex Offensive literally rewards players for playing, allows them to chase a certain item yet keeping the element of RNG in terms of rolls, and at the same time it's actually fun to play. I saw one reply to Goff's tweet asking about the activity and one kid replied with, "It's good but it's repetitive. I'm like, kid, where have you been for the past 5 years? The thing us Destiny players like is the fact that mods like these are repetitive but rewarding at the same time. Destiny has always been repetitive, it's just for the majority of its life it's been repetitive and not really rewarding. But repetitive mods are completely fine when they are rewarding but still keeping an element of RNG which is addictive at the same time. That's what we like. We like to grind a mod over and over and over. It's the element of RNG, that random roll on that weapon we've been chasing, which is addictive. That's what we like to play for." So with the Vex Offensive, you can buy weapon frames. Get said amount of kills with weapon type and you're rewarded a roll on said weapon you choose. And you can repeat this process for as long, basically, as you keep playing, as these frames cost Vex Mine components, which are also rewarded from the Vex Offensive. So farming for that perfect rolled weapon is something you can do here, which is great. And to be honest, it fits what I felt Shadowkeep did indeed in the end need. Now going forward, I do hopefully add the addition to farm for armors too, as well as a certain few weapon archetypes that ain't available here yet. Now the Menagerie did start out as being an amazing addition, probably the best PvE addition to the franchise. Bungie then did nerf the game mode via taking away an exploit which most players only played the mod for. Bungie claimed it was too rewarding. Problem is, the Vex Offensive is also seriously rewarding, because the amount of drops you get people is absolutely crazy. I just seriously hope Bungie do not nerf this activity. Now in saying that, people, the very foundation of the system in the reward the Vex Offensive offers is literally the very perfect foundation the Menagerie should have been implemented on. Rewards after every encounter. That would have been absolutely great. Now I feel it's a little too late for the Menagerie, but let's hope they don't make the same mistake again in nerfing a great PvE addition, one that rewards the player for playing. So yeah, guys, the Vex Offensive is a great addition to the game. Now on the 19th you also get the Vex Offensive Final Assault, which I'm hoping brings more challenge, more rewards, as that would be absolutely incredible. But yeah, guys, that's just my thoughts on the Vex offensive. In my opinion, it's a great addition. It's what Shadowkeep needed for the PvE player. Obviously, the raid's amazing too, but an activity where we can choose our reward, an activity where we can go into there knowing what we're going to get, even with the element of RNG with the role it's going to land with, that is something I feel the average D2 player seriously appreciates, and let's hope it don't go away. And on that note, we have come to the end of the video. If you guys enjoyed it, leaving a like really helps out. Tell me your thoughts on the Vex offensive down below in that comment section. If you're new around here and want to see more Destiny 2 videos, be sure to subscribe. And if you never want to miss a video I upload, you can turn notifications on by hitting that bell button. But guys, thanks as always for stopping by. Hopefully you enjoyed the video, and hopefully I will see you on that next one.